kind of looks like a piece of light that's unraveling in midair. It was obvious it was gonna be more than a mistake. This is the launch film for the 2015 YouTube Music Awards. My name's Tarek and I'm the director of the project. I was attracted to the idea that we could create a very futuristic looking world with a retro technology like laser scanners. Lasers aren't typically used this way. I think most people, when they think lasers, imagine light shows dating back to the 70s. We were actually using lasers to create really precise typography and structural environments.
My name's Connor Grable. I'm a designer and animator. Our design process was a lot of play. We take 2D animations and we use a laser projector to project that through a volume of fog, and only then were we able to really see which ones worked and which didn't. This shoot was almost all experimentation. We figured out this trick where we see just a sliver of that moment of light being projected, floating in midair.
My name is Joe Picard. I was the director of photography on the shoot. If you were in the room while we were filming, you wouldn't see this hovering light. You would see a solid column of light. That hovering effect, that happens in the camera.
My name is Adam LeBay. I'm the CEO of Future Weapons Laser and Lighting Design. I've encountered scan rate problems in lasers before when filming, and usually you do everything you can to eliminate it. This is the first time we've actually taken that scan rate issue and turned it into a technique and created something beautiful out of it.
I've been inspired by optical illusions for a really long time, but had never seen anything quite like this. It looked like a room full of holograms.
So we decided to go full force and turn it into an architectural experience.
The designs served as a starting point. It wasn't until people walked into the space and we began activating them with our live controls that things really began coming together.
Once we understood how to manipulate this effect, we were able to design for it and actually control it live while shooting.
The kind of thing you could only create in computer graphics, we were able to do in real space.
And this whole project was us just staying up late, working hard to visualize something that we couldn't wait to see in the fog on a laser projector, and then having little get-togethers and watching it. And it's just friends hanging out.
The fun part about this project was how unpredictable it was. YouTube and Vice gave us the freedom to discover something. They trusted our process, and in the end, I think that we found something new that we hadn't done before. When you feel something coming together that you can't completely control, that's special.